and then you bend over, you suck in your stomach, and then you breathe out, but you have to make a sound, so it would kind of sound like this. And you're really forcing the air, all that stale air, out of your lungs. And every time you do it, it's like you're filling your lungs with more and more fresh air that's full of oxygen. Well, just that breathing exercise, like 10 times, 3 times a day, doing that was just amazing for a lot of people. And still, even if you do it now, just before you go out for a walk or before you get on your trampoline, and let me say this about the trampoline. If you're a walker or runner, or you have other activities you like to do, you know, to keep your body in shape, the only reason we have to exercise at all is to move our lymph system. That's the only reason we have to exercise. A lot of us don't like going to the gym because it's not really natural. That's something that had to come about to assist us with getting the exercise that we need, because before people moved into the cities, most people lived on farms or they had
communities
where they were moving enough. You were stooping, you know, moving your arms, people lived on farms. So you got enough exercise that you didn't have to do what we call exercise. It was just natural, and that's the way it should be. However, we have to create that for ourselves. So the trampoline is one way to do it, and it's fun, and it's efficient. 5 minutes is the equivalent of running a mile, and your body will respond as if you've run a mile. So I usually have everybody do 15 minutes a day, and some people have to build up to that. So they start with however minutes they feel comfortable, and then add 30 seconds a day to that. Just 30 seconds a day, and they'll build themselves up to the 15 minutes, or 5 minutes 3 times a day on the trampoline, keeping your feet on the floor just like you're walking. And you move your arms like you're walking. If this were a visual show, I could, you know, show. But I'm hoping that everybody gets the idea.
Sure. Now, Dr. Michael Acoponce talked about breathing correctly. He talked about focused breathing and the use of oxygen, which is what you're talking about.
Absolutely. We brought him to a camp that I was involved with was all these professional athletes. Not one of them was over 25 years old. And now Dr. Acoponce was 72 at the time, and he also trained the cosmonauts and the Russian athletes, especially the ones that were bodybuilders, because he was the champion. He won every weightlifting class there was. I mean, and here's this tiny little man, you're thinking, how could he do it? Well, he had these guys come in. He put 300 pounds on a barbell and told each of the guys to come over and lift it. Not one of them could lift it. He went over, he lifted that up like it was just, a 5-pound weight. He just, and of course, everybody's mouth was open. And then he had each guy come back, and he corrected their posture, corrected their breathing, and then every one of them could lift it.
That's so profound.
That was profound. And so, and he said to them, breathing is everything. He made a statement about American athletes. He said, American athletes look beautiful, but he said, they're sick. And he said, they're going to be sick because they don't know how to breathe. I thought, wow, that's amazing. And so that day was a turning point for a lot of those athletes, because they started working with him and learning about the breathing and everything. But what's happening now is we're down to about 15% oxygen in the air. Now, if you live around a lot of trees and a lot of vegetation, it might be a little higher. That's not enough to keep any of us healthy. So at this point, we should be taking some form of oxygen. There is a capsule form. It's a magnesium peroxide that I use, and I have the people that come to me use. And it's a magnesium peroxide. It's called OxyCleanse. The reason why I like that one, I've used all of the different oxygen products. That one is the most balanced, and so I like that one the best. So, and I've been using that one for the last 19 years, and the results are always consistent, and you feel better. After a week, you don't have any smell to the waist. And you'll start having a lot of energy, and you'll just notice, wow, gee, my stamina is, wow, I mean, I don't feel tired. And so that's important to know. There are oxygen drops that people can get. Again, I like the magnesium peroxide because it goes into the intestines, and all of our organs have an ending point in our intestines. And so as it goes into the intestines, it can kill parasites and pathogens and all of that. And so it really, really helps with the health and the cleansing process and removing from our systems life forms and things that we don't even know is there.
Can you share with us about the biophotonic energy lymph detox? The biophotonic world is also part of new energy medicine. And I want you to share about it and what you've learned with the biophotonic energy lymph detox and why you're doing it.
Okay. The reason I do that is because it is the most effective in removing the protein blockages in the lymphatic system. The BELD system, BELD stands for Biophotonic Lymphatic Detox and Drainage. It is a technology that is an LED technology that is made specifically for breaking up the protein blockages in the lymphatic system, no matter where they are. So it is a solution to removing the protein blockages. Now, with manual lymphatic drainage, all we could do is remove the surface fluid, but we could not affect the cause of the fluid. So now we can remove the blockage, and that's the cause of everything, all the diseases and everything. And so it is a new paradigm. It is an innovation in lymphology.
Are these light-emitting diodes? How does it work?
Okay. What it does is the negatively charged lights in different, they're calibrated in different resonances or what people would call frequencies, but that's kind of a misnomer, but it gives people an idea because they can think of radio frequencies, and it's like, well, if you move to this station, it's 12-something, this one is 9, this one is 8. So the different frequencies or resonances that are required based on the substance that's causing the blockage that is also captured at the time that the upset occurs or that the chemical goes into the body. As the protein coagulates because of that's the effect that it has on that. We call that trapping. Whatever the substance is also trapped with that. So the light-emitting diodes are, they work like liquid crystals, which our cells work like that too.
Are they pulsed?
Yeah, they are pulsed.
Okay.
And the pulsing is what the different frequencies are, what the different resonances are. It is a light, all of the different resonances are negatively charged. That is because all of the protein blockages and all of the disease